Welcome back, lawn lovers. BW here.
I have a full spectrum of sprinklers that I use on my lawn in various places and situations. This is a big lawn, so I use some big sprinklers. Today I'll be testing my newest sprinkler, the Rainbird 6504 Falcon. What I'll be testing for is how long it takes me to deliver a half inch of water and how the amount of water delivered varies from the sprinkler head to the end of its spray pattern. I have a set of cute little measuring cups that I bought online somewhere a few years ago. You can look for something like this online, or use any type of container that has vertical sides, like a tuna can. Then just measure the depth of the water in the tuna can with a ruler. These cute little guys don't have vertical sides, but they are marked with measurements. Essentially, these are just little rain gauges, and you can use a set of rain gauges if you have some. Having a set allows me to measure several areas at once. It makes things go a lot faster. It's best to do this experiment on a calm day, but I have a 3 mph breeze today, so I hope that doesn't affect it very much. This sprinkler is supposed to spray a 45-foot radius, or a 90-foot diameter, so I stepped off my measuring cups at 3 paces, or about 9 feet each, for a total distance of 36 feet. I played with this sprinkler a little bit when it first arrived, and I knocked down the distance just a touch with the adjusting screw on the top of the rotor. I've found in the past that doing this tends to tighten up the water distribution a little, and keeps the end of the spray pattern from diminishing into an insignificant amount of water being delivered. It really doesn't matter how far the sprinkler will spray if it's not delivering very much water. I have a soil moisture sensor from my weather station buried 4 inches deep, just 6 feet to the left of the white sending unit that you can see in the old sandbox, just a little farther from the sprinkler than the first measuring cup. I found from experience that it takes about 1/2 inch of water for it to register an increase in the soil moisture, and it takes my other big sprinkler about 1 hour and 10 minutes to deliver that amount of water. The sprinkler's spraying about 7 feet beyond the last measuring cup, so it's spraying a radius of about 43 feet, or a total diameter of 86 feet, so this sprinkler lives up to its expected performance. This watering took 1 hour and 20 minutes or 10 minutes longer to register an increase in the soil moisture, but I can't say that this sprinkler doesn't deliver as much water as the other, because as it turned out, the wind did have an effect on the spray pattern. The wind is coming from behind the sprinkler, so I had to set the arc of the sprinkler a certain amount larger than a half a circle to compensate for the wind blowing the water forward at the ends of the arc. Therefore, the time it takes for the sprinkler to make a complete sweep increases, and that increases the amount of time it takes to deliver the 1/2 inch of water in front of the sprinkler. So all in all, I believe this sprinkler does deliver as much water as claimed. But wait, we haven't actually checked the measuring cups yet. As the cup fills, it almost seems like you can see the grass growing. Let's take a look. Starting with cup number 4, I see that it contains just under 1/4 inch of water. Cup number 3 contains just over 1/4 inch of water. Cup 2 contains just under 1/2 inch of water. And cup number 1 contains almost exactly 1/2 inch of water. I think it's fair to say that this sprinkler lives up to its billing. But more importantly, we have also discovered that we need to overlap our spray patterns to achieve an even distribution of water to the lawn. If I now place the sprinkler at the other end of the measuring line, and water again, it will give me close to an even 3/4 of an inch of water along the entire measuring line. That's how most in-ground irrigation systems are designed to operate. But I only want to deliver 1/2 inch of water without having to move the sprinkler so many times. I can reduce my having to move the sprinkler in half by overlapping my spray only halfway. That gives me an even 1/2 inch of water over a measuring line that is 50% longer than just one sprinkler arc, and I can get my watering done without having to move the sprinkler as much. In a nutshell, if you have a rotary sprinkler, you'll need to overlap your spray patterns in order to evenly water your lawn, and you can find out how much you need to overlap by conducting this experiment yourself. As for the new sprinkler, I love it. I can walk right up to it and adjust it without getting all wet like I do with the other big sprinkler with the swing arm thingy that splashes so much water. It's a little bit touchier to adjust though, and requires a small screwdriver to make an adjustment. A 3/4-inch professional contractor grade garden hose and good water pressure are recommended for a sprinkler this big. I really like this sprinkler, but I may miss that sweet song the old sprinklers used to sing in the summertime. Don't forget to subscribe, and remember, you can do it!